Bravo.
Hi. Yes, I'm Shridhar. I do jokes and news. That's what I do. Let's begin with some global topics. Yeah, there's a whole climate change debate in this world. Not on the news channels. We don't do that. There's a 16-year-old girl called Greta Thunberg from Sweden who's leading the climate change discussions by bunking school. I'm like, Greta, where's your homework? I can't imagine being her class teacher. She can't be like, Greta, where's your homework? Greta will be like, how dare you? But Greta is from Sweden. Now, Sweden is famous for two things. One, IKEA, the furniture store. And the second is Volvo, the car company. Greta hates cutting trees. And driving cars. So Sweden's like, oh shit. There's a whole RA forest debate also that happened. People are like fighting like mad on Twitter and everywhere else. In all this chaos, people actually missed out the real reason why the environment is under threat in Bombay. This is Sanjay Gandhi National Park. Because this national park is called Sanjay Gandhi National Park. That's exactly why the wildlife population is not growing. Some of you don't know who Sanjay Gandhi was. I hope he was successful though. just kidding. But it's all fun though. Mumbai has been great in the last 1 month. Have you seen the latest Big Boss episodes? The Maharashtra elections. What fun, right? So much entertainment. There was so much confusion, right? And across the city, people were afraid to gather in groups. Because if they're gathering in groups, governor would come and ask them to form the government. But finally, there was some clarity. People thought Uddhav Thackeray will become the CM and everybody was quite okay. In the morning, suddenly, Devendra Fadnavis made us realize where they say Mumbai is a city that never sleeps. Because nobody knows when the government will change. Fadnavis looked very confident in that oath-taking ceremony. He was taking oath as if he had the support of Karnataka MLAs also. Not just Maharashtra. Yes. Great. Have you guys watched KBC, the show? Kaun Banega Crorepati? I think it's my favorite show. Yeah, because I'll tell you why. In this show, my favorite part is there's something called as an audience poll. This audience poll, the audience collectively every single time gets the right choice. Isn't this? And then elections happen. In more political news, there's this whole debate and discussion also around something called as electoral bonds. Electoral bonds, if you don't know, basically lets you donate as much money as you want to any political party anonymously. It's great. And Congress is very angry about this. They're like, this will lead to corruption. And BJP is like, bro, how do you know? They're like, it's corruption, we know. But I think Congress should be happy about the electoral bonds, if anything, right? Because if somebody is donating money to Congress, they would want to stay anonymous. But we also saw the entire exciting episode of Chandrayaan 2 live telecast. You guys saw that? Clap if you saw the episode. Few of you. Others, please go to Pakistan. But no. It's quite exciting though. I think firstly, let's give it up for ISRO, yeah? What a great job they've done. Now, I'm very proud of this organization because ISRO made an entire nation of 1 billion people wake up at 2 a.m. in the night to stare at a graph. I'm not kidding. The live telecast was x-axis, y-axis and 3 lines. Whatever time they had left, they were showing Modiji. Very exciting. All these scientists in ISRO, they had a big mission at hand that night, right? Which is to keep Modi occupied. every few minutes they're going and talking to him. They're like, sir, do you need chai? I was like, no bro, I'll make it myself. At one point, I saw this scientist trying to explain the graph to him. He was like, Modi ji, imagine those three lines in the graph represent country's GDP. It's slowly landing. Quickly reach there. But, you know, I don't know if you guys have used Google Maps. Most of you would have done it. Google Maps navigation is great. But the problem is, 50 meters before the destination, it stops. You're in the middle of the road wondering, where's the building? Now, ISRO used Google Maps for Chandrayaan 2. Yes. Almost there. Like, where's the moon now? But these scientists are very humble people. So the scientists came out to give a press statement saying that we tried really hard. We could not maintain contact with this Vikram lander probe. Sorry. Okay. And Indians were obviously not very happy about this because we don't accept failure so easily, right? They're like, ISRO, for us, you have not failed. For us, you have succeeded. He was like, bro, it's a science mission. We have things to do, right? I'm not a politician. But I still had some hope. I thought we will be able to establish the communication again with this probe. But my hopes got crashed when Arnab Goswami started shouting loudly at the Vikram lander. He was like, Vikram lander, are you there? This is Arnab from Mumbai studios. No response. I'm like, if something does not respond to Arnab Goswami, it is not functional. But people become emotional on Twitter. They were posting stuff like, Vikram lander, we know you're there. Don't worry, Modi ji will come and get you. But the happiest people though were Pakistanis. Pakistan was losing their mind on Twitter. In fact, Pakistan's science and technology minister tweeted saying that India has failed. It was quite shocking because I didn't know that Pakistan had a science and technology minister. If anything, I think Pakistan should be grateful to India, right? If not for Aryabhatta, nobody in the world would know the number of moon missions they've done. And most of you must be wondering why ISRO is so good at its job. It's because ISRO is based in Bangalore. Now, I'll tell you why, okay? If in Bangalore, every day on your way to work, you have to spend like 3 hours in the traffic, the only thing you want to do is get the hell out of the world. So, every day, these scientists reach workplace with a lot of motivation. They're like, bro, this year we will send Chandrayaan, next year we can go. Anyways, you know, you can have all the agencies in the world telling you that there's an economic slowdown, like IMF or World Bank or any other organization, right? But the only time Indians will realize there's a slowdown is when the onion prices go up, right? Yeah, apparently it's so bad that government is importing onions from Egypt, which I think is a good thing. We'll get good onions. Because, I mean, who knows better than mummies? All right, that's been my time. Thank you so much for being a lovely audience.